Now to a Fox News alert, the situation appears to be unraveling in Ukraine. Is the Obama administration doing enough to respond to this crisis? And what should we be doing? Joining us now is Congressman Adam Kinzinger. Congressman, thanks a lot for joining us this morning. So how exactly should the U.S. be responding? It looks like a very murky situation unfolding even as we speak. What's our posture toward Ukraine, do you think?
Well, I think obviously, you know, there's no discussion of any military interaction or anything, but I think, you know, sanctions on travel, joining with the EU to ensure that the leadership that has been very oppressive to the Ukrainian people is punished for that. But there's been some very positive developments today, and I think it's important to see, you know, there's been this kind of east-west struggle that it seems like the West has been very slow to recognize is actually happening. And the Obama administration seems to continue to try to grovel to Vladimir Putin and try to make him happy, and Putin is really kind of bringing the pieces of the Soviet Union back together. And this was a huge deal, and it appears that the people are prevailing, although we're by no means done and out of the woods yet. And this would be a huge blow to Russia and a huge victory for the West, and it's important that we stand with the people of Ukraine, and the president stop making on the one hand the government this, but then on the other hand the protesters this kind of middle ground mushiness. He needs to be very clear that Ukraine should align itself with the West, and we'll be there for him.
But I mean, Russia supplies about 25% of the natural gas to the EU. If they were to cut that off, that would not be a small thing. The economic ripples would hurt us, no?
Well, yeah, I mean, it could be hurtful. We have the obviously very strong energy reserves here, and I think that's important to mention that, because as we talk about the development of our own energy and potentially exporting of natural gas, we can actually continue over the next decade or so as we develop this to be a counter to the Russians using that kind of power. You have to look just as far in Hungary, too. I was in Hungary a couple of months ago, and look, they signed a civilian nuclear deal with the Russians.
Right.
The Russians gave them a ton of money to do it, and the Russians are trying to slowly build that Soviet Union back together again, but this Ukraine situation could be a huge blow to them, and a very positive movement for freedom if it continues as it's been over the last 24, 48 hours.
So the White House announcing in the president's budget for next year there'll be no entitlement cuts at all, won't even reduce spending at all on entitlements, but it looks like the administration does want to cut pay for military personnel. Is this the correct priority in your view?
You know, oh, absolutely not. I mean, this is sad. So we've gotten to a point somehow where it's easier to talk about cuts to the military and to those that are sacrificing every day. I'm a military pilot. You know, I'll tell you, before we can have a really grown-up discussion about what the real drivers of our debt are. I mean, on Social Security and Medicare, we can talk about reforms for a younger person. Myself, I'm 35 years old. If you have to make adjustments for me, that's fine. I'm not really planning on Social Security being there anyway, so I'm happy to take adjustments to save them for current seniors and
right.
those nearing retirements. But what's happening is these cuts are going on the backs of people that are on their third and fourth deployment. I think we can talk about, you know, retirements in the military and what's happening there for new people coming in. But we are unable, for some reason in Washington, to have a grown-up discussion with the American
right.
people about what's really happening.
Right. I mean, if you asked your average 35-year-old, would you take your retirement benefits 2 years later, 35 years
sure.
from now, in exchange for not cutting the pay to people who are defending your country? I think most people would say, of course. It's crazy. Congressman,
yeah,
I'm sorry, we're out of time. I really appreciate your coming
sure.
on and adding that perspective as a military pilot. As well as
you bet. It was great being here. Thanks, and thank you for bringing that attention to an important subject.
Thanks a lot.